Inspiration Healthcare is a global supplier of medical technology for neonatal care. Our goal is to provide high-quality, innovative products that help to improve patient outcomes. Inspire rPAP is a revolutionary neonatal resuscitation system that delivers pressure support with low imposed work of breathing. Its unique design combines the ability to administer inflation breaths with all the clinical benefits of the fluidic flip nasal CPAP technology, whilst facilitating safe transfer of infants to the NICU. The new Inspire rPAP system has been designed to deliver a range of clinical benefits: resuscitate infants immediately in the delivery room, maintain the infant's airway using the same device for nasal CPAP, provide a stable mean airway pressure with a low imposed work of breathing, and to help reduce the rate of intubation. This training video is split into five sections: an equipment overview, how to set up the Inspire rPAP driver and generator, how to use nasal prongs or face mask for resuscitation, how to maintain the infant on nasal CPAP ready for transfer, and finally, how to set up humidification as an option with the Inspire rPAP system. Section 1, Equipment Overview. Before using the rPAP system, you will need the following equipment: the Inspire rPAP driver complete with oxygen tubing, the Inspire rPAP generator and resuscitation circuit, a nasal prong adapter with nasal prongs and a nasal prong sizer. The nasal prongs are color-coded and come in four sizes: extra small, small, medium and large. If face mask resuscitation is required, you will also need a mask adapter with an appropriate sized face mask. The face masks come in three different sizes: 00, 0 and 1. A headband for fixation, and for ongoing respiratory support, an optional humidification circuit is available. Section 2, how to set up the Inspire rPAP driver and generator. The first step in the setup process is to connect the rPAP driver to a blended air and oxygen supply. To do this, connect the oxygen tubing to the gas inlet port on the driver and connect the other end of the oxygen tubing to the flow meter. Connect the generator and resuscitation circuit to the driver. There are two outputs on the driver, one for targeting peak inspiratory pressure, PIP, and the other for delivering continuous positive airway pressure, CPAP. Connect the 15mm PIP line to the female gas outlet port and the 6mm CPAP line to the male gas outlet port. Next, set the flow and pressure settings for the infant. Set the flow meter to the required flow rate, up to a maximum of 15 litres per minute. To set the PIP, occlude the nasal prong interface, ensuring a nasal prong is fitted. Occlude the gas outlet and turn the PIP control knob until the desired PIP level is set. The final step is to set the CPAP. To do this, occlude the nasal prong interface and turn the CPAP control knob until the desired CPAP level is achieved. Please note, a flow rate of 12 litres per minute will supply a flow of 4 litres per minute to the PIP line and a flow of 8 litres per minute to the CPAP line, generating a CPAP of approximately 5 centimetres of water. Please refer to the flow and pressure tables in the rPAP driver instructions for use to set the prescribed pressure for the infant. Section 3, how to use the nasal prong or face mask for resuscitation. Please refer to Section 2 to check the PIP and CPAP levels are correct prior to resuscitation. Resuscitation can either be performed using a standard face mask or a nasal prong. The Inspire rPAP generator will be packaged with the prong adapter already attached. To perform resuscitation nasally, select the appropriate size nasal prong for the infant using the nasal size guide. It is recommended that the largest size prong appropriate for the infant is used. Next, fit the nasal prong to the nasal prong adapter on the Inspire rPAP generator. When ready to begin resuscitation, align the rPAP generator and nasal prongs to the nose. Using a gentle motion, insert the nasal prongs into the infant's nares. Resuscitate by placing and removing your finger over the gas outlet to trigger inspiration and expiration. Alternatively, if performing face mask resuscitation, select the appropriate size face mask for the infant and attach to the mask adapter. Remove the nasal prong adapter and replace with the mask adapter. When ready to begin resuscitation, place the face mask over the infant's nose and mouth and resuscitate by placing and removing your finger over the gas outlet to trigger inspiration and expiration. Section 4, how to maintain the infant on nasal CPAP ready for transfer. Once stabilised, the infant can be maintained on nasal CPAP. To do this, first fit the headband onto the infant by gently placing it under the infant's head. Pass the headband from the nape of the neck over the infant's ears and secure it using the side tab. Ensure that the central support tab on the headband is in the midline position, removing any excess material with scissors. If a face mask has been used for resuscitation, select the appropriate size nasal prong for the infant using the nasal size guide and fit it to the nasal prong adapter. It is recommended that the largest size prong appropriate for the infant is used. Whilst ensuring that the infant is in an optimal condition, remove the mask adapter from the rPAP generator and replace it with the nasal prong adapter. Align the rPAP generator and nasal prongs to the nose and the central support tab. Using a gentle motion, insert the nasal prongs into the infant's nares. Secure the rPAP generator using the central support tab on the headband. Place the felt straps either side of the headband and secure using the additional Velcro strips. Turn down the PIP control knob to the minimum setting on the rPAP driver. Adjust the flow meter and set the CPAP to the desired pressure. Please refer to the flow and pressure tables in the rPAP driver instructions for use to set the prescribed pressure for the infant. Take care to ensure that the infant is comfortable and that the infant's vision is not obscured. Make sure that the straps are not too tight against the skin and check the rPAP generator is positioned correctly. The infant is now ready to be transferred safely to the NICU. Section 5. How to set up humidification with the Inspire rPAP system. If humidification is required, disconnect the CPAP line at the mid-circuit connection point and attach the clear connector to the humidification adapter included in the pack. Connect this to the humidification chamber. Then connect the proximal pressure port of the heated wire circuit to the rPAP generator at the same mid-circuit connection point and the other end to the humidification chamber. Please refer to the manufacturer's instructions to operate the humidifier. The infant is now ready to be transferred safely to the NICU.